are we? Oh no. Oh, the frames are weird. Oh, it's been so long. Oh Jesus. Oh my sweet lord. No, we're going back down. Goodbye, world. Goodbye. Okay, no, but seriously, I am back with another episode of the Let's Play. Welcome back, everybody. Can we try and... How do we do... There we go. The old little stupid intro that everyone does. Anyway, we're back. And I have stuff to do. I went mining for more diamonds. Anyway, so last time, where we left off, we built a taco bus, and that got me thinking. This Let's Play is supposed to be fun and entertaining to watch, and the last 45 episodes have been pretty boring and dull, because I've started projects and not finished them and had great ideas and stuff, so my New Year's resolution, although a bit late, since I didn't actually have one, is now to try and be a better builder and follow through on projects more. So, we're back. I guess I was trying to collect levels and stuff for enchanting new tools, because, yeah, I kind of lost a lot of stuff, but I logged in, and apparently, where I had left off grinding levels, I forgot to put out all the fire, and there... Wow, there is a lot of fire. So, Mr. Blaze, sorry, bud. You're gonna have to go. What's on this? Nothing. Oh, sweet. Spooky. Spooky scary. Okay, so... There's fire everywhere. I don't know... Oh no. Oh, it's in here too. Oh, why can they see out? Why can they see out? Crud, that's not supposed to happen. Apparently, I have angered them. Somehow. Or something. I was AFK. You all remember the beauty that is the Nether. And now it's on fire again. I put out all the fire. So we're just gonna leave this for now. I don't need the levels right away. I don't need the levels right away. So we can go over here and meander on back. And we'll come back at a later date when they are not mad at us and when the world is not on fire. So anyway, guys, my plan today, besides showing you my once beautiful, now completely burnt Nether, is to, we're gonna build a new pumpkin patch. And is this on far? Yeah. Yeah, it is. Huh. Weird. Didn't I already lock world difficulty? I don't know. 1.8's weird. I have no idea. Anyway, we're back. And today, I actually want to work on making this better. So, last year, for those of you who remember, I built this giant frame for a pumpkin. It is 16 by 16. And I was like, hey guys, my favorite food is pumpkins. And I think that we should make a pumpkin farm, because pumpkins are just so bae. And so we made this giant pumpkin head, right? Giant pumpkin head. And our goal was to make it into a giant pumpkin, and inside of which we would have pumpkins and cool stuff such as that to farm pumpkins with. Pumpkins and sugarcane, and also an egg farm for the little chickensies for eggs. So we would essentially have everything that we needed to make pumpkin pie, which is just the best food. I think I might have said that my favorite food was pumpkins. It is not. Straight pumpkins are kind of nasty. Also, really quickly here. Okay. Actually, I need this, but... Good donkey. Good horse thing. I need to name you one day. Being bad about that. So anyway, today, I have a better idea. In my resolution for wanting to be a better builder and all that cool stuff, I was like, you know what? Wouldn't it be awesome if instead of having this really derpy giant pumpkin that would take forever to build and that would annoy me and be an eyesore once I was finished, how about instead I make like a cool little farm in the countryside, right? Like a little, you know, when you go camping you see them, they're little weird. I don't know how to describe them. They're just kind of cool little cabins out in the woods. You know, old rustic cabins, or farmhouses, I guess you would say. And then out to the side, you would have a pumpkin patch with some scarecrows and stuff. It would look much better, and it would fit the mood of fall quite a bit better. Because yes, it is almost September. And if you recall, there are 12 months. I actually just figured this out the other day myself, or I made the connection. I knew that there were 12 months, but if you divide that into 4 seasons, then that would be 3 months per season. So, from my figuring, the beginning of September is in fact the beginning of August. Not to mention that's when all the kidlings go back to school, and that kind of marks the beginning of winter and the dark months. But anyway, after I take this down, I will start with the building of it, because we actually have quite a lot of work to do with it. I want to try this new type of building. I subscribed to a new building channel for like a day. He unfortunately stopped doing building content and started doing Draw My Thing episodes, and that's all he's been doing. His name was Green, I think, and he's quite a cool commentator. He commentates very well. Has quite a few subscribers. I might put a link down below because I will be using his design for kind of his design for a rustic house, but not completely. And it looks really good, I think, so that's what we're going to be using. And I also want to kind of mix it with some ideas of my own, because he just shows you how to do the outside of buildings. You have to do the inside, or at least he did show you the outside of how to do buildings. Anyway, so first off, the first thing that you must do is we gotta find... I also want to do something in those extreme hills. And I apologize, but I... 8. Okay. And we're on far. What other video setting? I don't play this much. Alternative rendering model. 5 to 10% vortex buffer objects. Can't remember if that's better on or off. I guess off, because I have it off. It doesn't really matter. I don't have any problems with frames in Minecraft anyway, so as long as I'm getting what I'm getting, I'm fine for recording. That's all we really need. Okay, so over here, and I kind of do like the fog. I don't get fog in any other worlds or anything. I only get it in my Let's Play, because in Vathos, it renders really far out, because that's how the config is set to. Anyway, I'm blabbering. I apologize. So, actually, I was going to do it in here, or somewhere along in this giant plains biome, right? But I don't think that we have a flat enough expansive plains. Well, we have this over here. I just wanna find a cool place for, you know, it's like a farm mill kind of thing. It has like big spires and stuff, and it's made out of spruce. At least a little bit of it is. And I just think it would be cool. I wanted to do like an old-fashioned, like a really cool thing over there with that little hole you guys see. And like, woo, it would be like a building inside of there, and it'd have windows and stuff, and like a little under area right there, like a cafe or something, I don't know. But I don't want to use that. We could do it here. We could do it right here among the poppies and roses. And I think that's what I'll do. I'll erect a pillar. And, you know, you'll have that view, you know, that view, that view, that view, that view. Be able to see the Yggdrasil. Also, I want to finish the Yggdrasil as well. Okay, so, build that up. And just do the derp of all derps. We can make an upside down, well, I'm not going to say it, because people would get offended, but we'll do that. It actually doesn't look as much like what I thought it would look like. Anyway, so I'm going to gather resources, mainly spruce, spruce, probably, maybe oak or spruce logs, I'm not sure which would look better, and then some cobblestone as well, which, it'll be nice to make a dent in our cobblestone resources. So, I'll be right back with you guys, and I will see you guys in a second. Crud. Just stopped recording and I find this. What is it? Is this one of those glitched arrows that is always here? Out of sight, out of mind? Maybe, I don't know. I've heard those cause like frame weirdness, but yeah, you can see that pretty well. I just need to remember to stay on this project, because otherwise it'll look ugly. Okay. Anyway, sorry. I found that arrow, and I thought that was kind of weird, so in case it glitched and, like, flew into the air, wanted to record that. Bruh. Okay, here we go, here we go. We have a crafting table, some of this stuff, some couple stairs. Good resources right here. Unfortunately, that's all we appear to have. I'll also take that red carpet. Very nice. Yeah, so what I wanted to do, pretty much, I said that I would gather resources, but I figured I'll kill two birds with one stone and tell you guys what it's going to be like. So, you know, obviously the farmhouse thing, which you guys will get once you see it start being built, and hopefully I can recreate it. I'm not very good at remembering step-by-step stuff, unless I do it, like, a few times, right? Some stuff I remember really well, some stuff I really don't. So, we'll take these. But anyway, it is basically, yeah, you guys will see. I'm gonna stop blabbering on about that. But the main part is going to be a big pumpkin patch thing. You know, like, if you see a lot of big YouTubers like Etho and stuff, he has made a giant wheat patch, or Chimney Swift has made a giant wheat patch. You know, just those really expansive things. I don't want to make it that big because I simply do not have, well, I have 27 pumpkin seeds, so we will see how big that is, but overall, it's going to be a big pumpkin patch with some reeds growing out alongside it, like maybe a big lake off to the side with a mill inside of it. And, no, we'll take some of this cobble, don't mind if I do. And do we have any wood? Any wood would be appreciated. No. It doesn't look like it. Crud. Anyway. Saplings. Some bone meal. More pumpkin. Okay. Yeah, but it's gonna be like a little farm thing off to the side. In fact, I might build that first, and then make the... I love this contraption. It's so much more useful in 1.8. And then make the farmhouse afterwards. So I'm going to gather up just the oak and spruce. In fact, I'm going to run over and grab some bone meal out of the little derpy food court bus that we made, because it needs to be used more immediately for this than for growing potatoes, since I have enough food to last me a few years. So we'll do that. I'll gather supplies, and then I will come back to you guys for the building aspect of it. I still don't have a way to get out of here. Pitiful. Absolutely pitiful. Okay. We got the stuff. We're doing the things. Enough jump cuts. Okay, everybody, we are back. We have tons of cobble, plenty of spruce. I'm keeping the oak wood as oak wood, so that we can just turn that into pillars and stuff. But the spruce wood will be turned into planks. Otherwise, I would say that it wasn't enough, but I think we should be fine. And if not, we can always come back. So, first, I'm going to feed the chickens. Right. I'm not just going to feed them. That'd probably be a lot better, but no, we're just going to go around and collect the eggs from this horribly insane chicken farm that one day I will utilize and get, like, 10 stacks of feathers from. It's literally insane. I don't think I'll be able to pick up all of the eggs down here. Yeah, I'm full up. Look at this! These guys can't even get out. You jump down there, and you instantly get, like, a stack and a half of eggs. Oh, golly. This is almost too efficient of an egg farm, because you pick them up faster than you can literally throw them, so I don't think we're gonna have any trouble getting eggs for our pumpkin pie. The only trouble will be getting out of here without picking up more eggs. That's totally... Oh, it's too good. Oh, the chicken farm is literally too overpowered. have babies. I don't even think that those hatched anything. Holy moly. Yeah, so pretty much you just need to step in there, and you have enough eggs for, like, 15,000 pumpkin pies. So that works. That part of the farm is working very well. I might make that look nicer, but it would be a pain, an absolute pain, to try and work on that at all with all those chickens down there. But I just throw down eggs, and I give them seeds and stuff from farming. And their numbers are up quite a bit. I believe that there might be, like, there are quite a few. I could go over there and press F3, but I think that I don't really want to see how many chickens there are. And there's this guy. Hello. Silly guy. Okay, so I'm going to leave this here just for now. So we'll have this and this. And here I will cook a potato, just because I want that out of my inventory. And we will start designing the farm. So I kind of think that it would be... Okay, there's something down here. I just want to explore this real quick. I kind of think that it would be nice if the house... Jeez, that's actually a really nice hole. I don't know if I want to cover that up. Well, how about this? We will remember that it's there. Yeah, we'll remember that it's there, and we'll just build the house over here. So the house, I think, can go like here. If we cleared out this little one block area here, that gives us plenty of room to build around here. And it's close to the cave and everything. And then the pumpkin farm, I think, would be cool if we came over like here. You know, if that was the house, then over here is the pumpkin farm. You get a little bit of terrain leverage and stuff. Over here, there's already a pond going for the sugarcane, which is really nice. I just need to update a block, I believe, and this will start flowing. No, actually. Why you being difficult, Sand? There we are. Whatever. I honestly don't care. I don't care, Sand. So we can get our sugar cane and put it down here. Not really exactly what I had in mind, but yeah, it's close enough. Okay. Just make it look kind of natural, I guess. Here. And here. And then we can get more from over the sugar cane. I like building, I really do. And especially like terraforming is especially fun. There we go. Okay, so we have the sugarcane part done. Now we just need to clear out this area right here, which I believe I'm going to have to get a new shovel for. Yeah, my tools are dead, effectively. It's gonna break, there we go. Okay, so that's broken. My tater is done, but we can start doing these. There we go. Some cobble fences. Mm-hmm. And then we will turn some of this into the spruce eels. See if we can do... No, that won't work. How did you make the fences again? You did like... Yeah, you did this and... That for the fences, yeah, okay. Gotcha, so. We'll just make a few fences here. Six, yeah, six, and two, there we are. Okay, so we can experiment with designs right here. And you guys can tell me what you like best. So, I could do it like, right, so. It's up here. We have... Go down like this and stuff. And then when it reaches a corner, we could act. That doesn't work. Or we could do it the other way around and go. Boom. 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 That doesn't work either. We need something that mobs can't get into. It doesn't really matter around here, though. Like, there aren't even that many mobs to get into anything. Maybe we could just put a torch on there. I don't have any coal. Have to go down here. May dog. Hello, doggy. How are you? Okay, so. Do that, there. And that will cover all four corners. Except we need it to be a little bit better lit. So we can come over here and say... I really wish that these connected. Because that looks dumb. Right? That looks dumb. Another thing we could do... let me think. Okay guys, now we are back at the base. I needed some more materials, such as a better shovel, which we have. Had one in reserve, but I have this really cruddy iron sword. Ah, crud, I already had an unenchanted diamond sword. Whatever. Waste not, want none. I also need lapis. We're going to enchant this really quick. We need all that lapis for this. Let's do that. And does it need 30 levels? No, it just needs 3. Okay, so we'll definitely have sharpness 3. That's it. Sharpness 3 sword. Rip. Well, here. Let's enchant the other one as well. If we're gonna do that. Put that back. Right there. And we'll get this bad boy out, and we'll see if we can get him to be any better. Whew. I would rather have sharpness, to be honest. Like, that's a good sword if I'm hunting for enderpearls or something. I just needed stuff for the shovel. Do we have any wool? We have... not really. We go down and kill some spiders. Unless they are... no, they're right here. My friend! Spider eye... cruddy stuff. Sadly. And we also can do that. Okay, cool. I want to make a bed. A bed. To get over there and sleep. But I guess I can grab the one from the Yggdrasil. Or just kill some spiders or shear sheep. Anyway. Going back there. Okay, guys. I had not realized how much time we'd used up. Anyway. If I can get within here. Without being killed. Maybe. Yeah, we're good. So, I've laid out this kind of thing. I'm imagining having water around here, in this little crevice, and down here. I'm not really sure what this is, just kind of maybe be a little feature of the farm. And, jeez. I'm surrounded. I'm not used to hard mode. But, in between this episode and next episode, because by now the render will be almost... unuploadable because it'll be too big of a file size, but I'll fill this in with water, put the pumpkins in, maybe put the sugarcane in as well, and then next time I will show you the progress and maybe make a few last changes to it. In the meantime, you guys can tell me what you think about this pumpkin patch, and then we'll start working on the rustic house to go with it, and maybe even put like a little fishing cabin over there or something. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, always leave a like. It is very appreciated. It always just makes me feel good. And tell me what ideas you have. I know a lot of you are really good builders. Look at this freaking... oh gosh, creeper, no, please. Whoa! Stop it. And I would love to hear your feedback or tips or tricks or whatever. And yeah. Anyway, until next time, guys. Hope you're having a fantastic day. Llama 90, out.